Hello, guys. First off, we lost last time. So I simmed this one. First time simming, they gave me the win 24-20. So, yeah. And I'm also, on a side note, curious to see how far the Lions will advance against the Rams, no less. So, that's a huge advantage. Special teams. Okay, so let's sim this round and see what happens for the conference. Alright, we're playing against the Colts. And I see the Lions did not do well at all against them. Alright, so playing against the Colts in the conference, and the Rams play the Bears, actually. Really, the Bears? Bears aren't that good. But probably be the Rams. I imagine we'll probably face against the Rams, which is weird. Did the Giants make the playoffs? They did not, actually. But in real life, we did not play against the Colts in the playoffs. We actually played against the Raiders, and we beat the Raiders 16-3. So first, let's save this here. But I do believe we played against the Colts before. I do believe so. Let me check my thing. Oh, I guess we didn't. So it's a different team. So let's take a look at the team itself. Okay, it seems kind of split. Overall, they're slightly better. They have a better offense, but we have a way better defense. Special teams are even. They have a huge edge on quarterbacks. Retired running backs, they have definitely an advantage on wide receivers, but that's where it ends. We have an edge on offensive line, defensive line, and linebackers, and we are tied at defensive backs. So let's take a look at their roster. Well, yeah, Peyton frickin' Manning, and they gave him a 62 speed. That's generous. That's pretty generous for Peyton Manning. Oh, they're gonna be without Edgar and James though. That's gonna be incredibly helpful because the other guys aren't that good. Fullbacks weak. Paul Shields not very good. Receiving, they got Harrison. Terrence Wilkinson's their number two receiver is out. So they got to rely on a bunch of scrubby guys here. Tight ends are pretty strong though. We got Dillinger and Pollard. Left tackle solid. Left guard average. Centers average-ish. Right guard's good. Right tackle's fantastic. So they got some weak spots there. Left end is slightly above average. Right end is incredible right there. I believe they are a 4-3 team, too. Ellis Johnson's solid. Decent number two D-tackle. Left outside linebacker. He's very good. Middle linebacker's only slightly above average. But he is a rookie. Mike Peterson's solid, though. Cornerbacks are pretty good in. Tyrone Poole. Solid. Jeff Bears is also solid. The rest of the guys, free safety's pretty good. And strong safety's pretty solid as well. Kicker's good with Vander Jack. Young guy, he's average. Punter is slightly above average, but he's young. So yeah, they got some good players, mostly offensively speaking. Defensively, the front line is weak. I should be able to run the ball decently against them, in all honesty. the RCA Dome. I will say for the offseason, my biggest thing is the line. The line is my biggest thing right now, because defense-wise, we're pretty perfect. Offensively, the line's the biggest thing. Quarterback is too. Because Tony Banks, I don't have the biggest confidence in, and while I do love Trent Dilfer, he's a bit on the softer side. Knowing them that they are definitely going to be passing all games, so I'm not even going to bother with that other shit.
Right.
But then again, they don't have the most solid receiving core either, so we're just going to have to play it by ear. Ooh, yes. Wow. You see, the thing is that if I can just win at least one of these playoff games, then I feel like I've earned a right to say, okay, I can do this, I just had a string of bad luck. Okay. Oh, come on, really? No win, so I should be able to make it in. So, yeah, because I'm not going to... Oh, my God. Get... Yeah, because the biggest thing for me is I just... Because I know Peyton Manning likes to... Okay, maybe they're running the ball more than I thought they were going to. Oh, jeez. Goal line... Wow, why are they running the ball so much? I understand, like, they got a receiver out too, but, I mean, oh my God, what's with them in their, the problem is that PMA is so good right here, is that, even with some guys out, in reverse. Oh no, not Peter Bowlware. God damn it. Dime. he's only out for the game. He's not out for the season or weeks, so I at least will have him for future games. Damn it, come on, really? I think it was the same play, too. Little did they know back then how real he would be. Oh, come on. Alright, now they're really... I think they're punting, yeah. Where the sideline is, you just stretch out to make that catch. Smith will punt it away. Yeah.
Tell your line to protect out there.
Let's just keep it simple. Let's start with a little ball running. Thanks, Sharp. Finally catching one. I think I got him. Lewis. Alright, let's not give them too much time to work with. Oh gosh. Let the clock run down a little bit. Wow, Gash runs it in. Pretty solid, but it's still early in the game. I do not count Peyton Manning's Colts out whatsoever. Timeouts. Come on. Oh my God. That's close enough. Yeah, they're gonna get that. Okay, still ahead by 7. If Lewis gets the ball, I have a shot of maybe getting another score, because he's a great returner. No, it's Harris. Okay. Well, let's see what happens here. Oh, if it was Lewis, I would have done something there.
Give this one to your halfback.
Yeah, and there's no point. I should have hurdled.
Thank you.
well. Oh, Burris got hurt. Let the clock run down a tad. Let's wait till the clock runs down before I run the play.
So we reach the end of the third quarter with the Baltimore Ravens ahead of the Indianapolis Colts. 10-3. The team's descent for the fourth quarter of play. Belford hangs it on. Morris makes the top of the 3-2-yard gain.
Okay, we'll run the clock down. We'll kick a field goal. We'll be ahead by 10.
Field goal unit comes on the
Oh, nice. One more play.
Keep it on the ground here.
Yeah, because they got timeouts. Cash.
Hey, all we need to do is run some clock. Run that football in the middle. Defense showing with Delper hands it off. Peterson makes the top of the 3. Hey, all we need to do is run some clock. Run that football in the middle. Lewis takes it. Delper hands it off.
There we go.
The goal line, 2 yards.
and goal.
Keep this to the inside. Just need to run that clock.
Oh, they still got a timeout. Let's let the clock run down. Man, we shut their offense down pretty well. They had some, a couple good passes, but that's really been it. Let the clock run down. And yeah, that's... we finally won a playoff game. Oh, thank God.
The end of the game. The final score is Baltimore 13, Indianapolis 3. For James Brown,
so, it is possible to win... for me to win these playoff games. It's just, I just had a string of rough luck. Ooh. That's a part of the Madden challenge. Yes, of course they're playing the Rams. No, it was a close game against them too, the Bears. It's ironic because I remember when I did a franchise mode of Madden 03 with the Ravens, and I actually played against the Rams in the Super Bowl, and we beat them in overtime. So that's something interesting there. First, let's save more than anything. But yeah, I think we're going to call it good. I think I'm going to take a look at the final stats for all my players, actually, because I should have done that at the end of the regular season. It's just the way this has been going. It's so easy to flow through this mode because it has a nice minimalistness to it that it's kind of hard not to just get lost in the... Binks. Binks, percentage not very good. Interception count not very good. Yeah, the decent QB rating though, but yeah, not. Let's look at him. 100, actually. Yeah, not too bad in all things considering. Definitely not as much as completion, but definitely not as many touch interceptions. And of course, got Chris Redmond, the rookie. Yeah, I like how they kept his hat. Let's look at Lewis. Lewis did not do very well. I don't know why, but for some reason, it just didn't gel with this one. Let's look at Priest. Priest still hurt. Priest actually did better average-wise. Made some catches. Yeah, not so much there. I can't believe I have three fullbacks. The Quadre. Quadre actually did almost over 1,000 yards, almost. Look at Travis, 12 catches, 18. No touchdowns with him though. 4 catches, a touchdown. Ooh, let's take a look at receiving. Kick return, a lot of kick returns, 1 touchdown, 2 touchdowns, punt return. Sounds about right. Look at Shannon. 31 catches, more than his last season, a few touchdowns, but yeah, he should have done better than that. Look at Ben Coates. Ben Coates is good. I should use Coates more. That's a mistake. Left tackle. Burnett just did not do much this year. McCary, not much there either. Let's look at Sam Adams. 6 sacks for him, that's pretty good. Saragusa, not the best. I got some stuff with him. Let's look at Bulware. Bulware, he did okay. He did get an interception, but no sacks, man. Well, I didn't really blitz my linebackers all that much. Look at Ray Lewis. Man, Ray Lewis didn't get anything. You guys also have to keep in mind that is the quarter length makes a huge difference. Callister, not much there. No interceptions with him. Couple with him. Trap, nothing. Woodson, 1 interception. Corey Harris. Not Chris, Corey. And nothing. How did my kicker do? 11 out of 19. That's super well. That's the best punting right there. But yeah, that's pretty much the stats for that this season I did. And next time you'll see me, I'll be playing the Super Bowl. So all that's left really is the Super Bowl, the Pro Bowl, and off season. I'm sure we play Pro Bowl in this. They do have the Pro Bowl stats. But yeah, we're going to call it good here. And yeah, guys, thanks for watching. Please subscribe and like the videos, and have a good day.